Hey guys, this is Shloka for Teespring. Thank you for joining me for this training series and welcome on board. As I've said in the past, this training is going to be free for all members of the Teespring community. So the first video will be geared towards newbies, though I'm sure that people at intermediate level will also derive some value from this and it can also serve as a good revision for them. The videos will keep getting added to the Teespring India group as and when I create them, mostly one video per week, and I'll try to cover everything in as much detail as possible in these videos, and I'll also be available in the group to answer questions that you might have after going through this video. And guys, let me know your feedback in the comment section, and if there is any stuff that I miss out in the topics that I'm going to cover now, and I'll make sure to cover it in the next videos. So the first question is why you should use Teespring for your print-on-demand business. Guys, Teespring is the first platform that put power in the hands of the sellers. Teespring started this print-on-demand revolution that we are witnessing today, and every other platform that is there now just followed in the footsteps of Teespring. Another great reason is that they have a great backing from the investors, plus they have their own big printing facility. So they are much ahead and much more reliable than all the new platforms that started floating out recently. And guys, the biggest reason for me is that they care about their sellers. I am a live example. I have been selling with Teespring for 4 years now, and I have stuck with them. And the only reason for that is that they have taken a very good care of me. So the things that I'll be covering in this video would be the mindset and the approach that you need to have for success in this business, and then selecting the niches in which you want to do your designs and doing the research in proper way so that you can come up with a t-shirt phrase which has a great chance of selling, and finally getting your designs done in the right way. So let's get right into it. So guys, the first thing I wanted to talk about is mindset. Even though it has got nothing to do with the technical aspect of selling shirts, believe me that positive mindset is vital. I'd even go on to say that it is one of the most important aspects which will determine whether you are going to have success or not in this business. You need to test a lot of things, and when you are going to do a lot of tests, there will also be a lot of failure. But failure is actually good. It means you are taking action, and it also means you know what doesn't work, which will in turn ensure you have a better understanding of the audience so that you can move on to things that actually work. Also, when starting out, it's important to have a realistic expectation. It's of utmost importance. You can't expect to find success in your first design. You may find it, but there's a very less chance that it will happen. But if you are doing 3 to 5 designs a day, approaching it in the right way, there's every chance that you'll hit success in some time. Consistency pays off in this business. Like, even after being in this business for 4 years, our failure to success ratio is 10 to 2. That is, out of every 10 campaigns we are doing, 2 of them are going to be winners, while 8 of them will fail. But when I say a winner, it means it gets sales in hundreds, 500s, and some designs even go on to get sales in thousands of numbers, which means that one good winner can pay off for a lot of failures and can also make you a lot of money on top of it. Also, you need to understand that the goal here is to advertise on Facebook and make money by selling shirts. So you need to spend money to make money. If you are getting into this for the first time, I would say you should have a budget of somewhere between $500 to $1,000 to spend on ads to give yourself a good chance to make a profit. It could be less for some, more for some. This is just an average that I could think of. I'll talk more about it in the coming videos when I talk about Facebook ads. And guys, I wanted to talk a little bit more about the expectation part. I'll be honest with you. Selling shirts was easier in 2014-2015. It is a bit harder now, but I'm there to guide you through the process. There are so many people who are still making a killing selling print-on-demand products, and there is no reason why you can't do it if you put in the hard work. Alright, so let's get to the fun part now. So one of the major decisions that you will have to make at the beginning is selecting the niches in which you want to sell the shirts. So before you do that, I wanted to give you a clear understanding of what a niche is. So a niche is basically the collection of audience that you will be putting your shirts in front of. For example, it could be a job like mechanic, or it could be a hobby like cycling, or it could also be a relationship like mom. So what are the considerations for selecting a niche? The first and foremost is that the people in that niche should be passionate enough to spend money to buy t-shirts or mugs for that interest. So by passionate enough, I mean, for example, I love watching television, but I'm not that passionate that I'll buy a t-shirt about watching television. But say I have a hobby, I love playing table tennis, and say I spend 1 hour playing table tennis every day. So that is something that I'm really passionate about, and if somebody gives me a shirt that talks about playing table tennis and it has a very nice message on it that I can relate to, there's a good chance that I'll buy that shirt. So the second consideration is that these people should be available to target on Facebook, because that is where we'll do advertising later on. Say you do a design for mechanics and you target Indian market, you'll not find enough audience to sell your shirts to. But you, for the same design, if you target to US market, you'll have enough number of people to target. Similarly, that holds true for US market also. So make sure that before even selecting a niche, you know that there is enough audience on Facebook. I'll talk about it more and probably also show you how to actually see if you have enough audience on Facebook. The third consideration is that these people should have enough money to spend on apparel. The more money they have, the more chances that there is that they will spend money on apparel, because say it will be considered a leisure to spend money on apparel. So the more disposable money they have, the better it is. I have seen that generally the older the demographics, the more disposable money they have to spend on apparel. And the fourth consideration is the competition that is in that niche, especially when you are started. And since this video is geared towards newbies, if it's a very competitive niche, I don't suggest newbies to get into that niche. All right, let's move on. So if you're just starting out, I would say that you pick five niches, and probably I can also show you how you can go about choosing the niches. So let me just open up Chrome here. So let's open teespring.com. Oops. Okay, yeah. So you can see that Teespring has a marketplace and there are various categories. So this is age, you can't advertise this on Facebook. So for example, family is there and hobbies are there. So somebody who's starting out, I recommend that you target hobbies and jobs, as people are really passionate about these things. If somebody is working in a job, that is something that they do day in and day out. So there's a good chance that they may want to buy a shirt for it. So let's open hobbies and jobs and see what we find out. So straight away we see cats. Cats is one of the big niches, though it's also very saturated. We have camping here, we have beer, bulldog, so there's something in the dog niche here, gaming. So like you can see guys, in the first page only, if we open the hobbies tab in Teespring marketplace, all the designs that appear on top are in different niches. So I would say that when you are starting out, you to give yourself a good chance of success, you should pick five, because I feel that it's not too much, it's not too less. Because if you pick just one niche, maybe you may select a niche that doesn't have enough audience, or the niche is too competitive. So if you select five niches, I think five is the perfect spot to be in. And I'll also talk more about the way you should select these niches. I just wanted to show you the place where you can go to see the niches that are there. So if these niches are appearing on the first page, there's a very good chance that people are making a lot of sales in these niches. Similarly, when we go to the jobs tab in Teespring Marketplace, we can see shirts for engineer. What else do we have? All right. We have nursing here. We have, okay, I catch bad guys. How about that? Okay, it's a tank top for in the police niche. This is a tank top in the nurse niche, and you can see that this is a layering of two niches, nurse niche and bodybuilding. So layering is another good way of getting really targeted. So say a person who is employed as nurse and also does weightlifting will relate really well to this, because two of her top interests in her life are being displayed on this shirt. So when a nurse who goes to gym feels this shirt, there is a very good chance that she will feel that this shirt is there just for me, right? So, all right. So like I mentioned, jobs and hobbies work well. So if you're just starting out, I would say that just go to Teespring Marketplace, do your research, and come up with five niches that preferably in jobs. Preferably that includes some jobs and some hobbies. Select the niches that are not too big, because if it's too big, there's a very good chance that it will be saturated, and there are bigger players in the market who have a lot of experience in these niches. So if you are starting out, you may not be able to compete very well with them. But also make sure that you don't go after a very small niche, otherwise you'll not have enough audience to sell. So I'd say something in the middle is the right way to approach and select a niche. So for that, I wanted to give you a very good idea. And what I call them is go after sub niches. And I have an example here for you. So say mechanic is the main niche, but mechanic is a very saturated niche. And like I said, there would be bigger players in this niche. So what you can do instead is go after a smaller niche, that is aircraft mechanics. I am saying this because I know that even this niche in itself has enough audience, and there are campaigns in this niche itself that have got sales in thousands. So that is what I mean when I say that you should go for niches that are somewhere in the middle, that's not too big or not too small. I have another example for you here. So for example, nurse is the main niche. What you could do is you can go after the sub niches. So one of the good sub niches in the nurse niche should be CNA, that is certified nursing assistant. Again, I have done shirts in this niche, so I know that this niche is good enough, and you could get decent sales in this niche. All right, so guys, I didn't want you to leave hanging at just theory. So I have gone inside my ads manager. So once you open your business manager and go to one of your ads account, and then you go to a campaign, you can come to this screen. So I wanted to show you that there is actually enough number of audience in the sub niches that I talked about. So here you can see that United States is selected as the location, and gender is women, and age is 18 to 65. So I wanted to show you the audience that is there inside this sub niche. So as you can see, okay, just let me just remove it and let me try to bring it back again. So I selected certified nursing assistant as an interest, and you can see the potential reach that's showing here is 390,000 people. So that is a good enough audience size
to go after a niche. If you come up with an extremely good design, good content, and design is in this niche, who knows, you could sell maybe 500 or 1000 units in of just a single design. But obviously then the content has to be top class. If we add more interest to it with the word CNA or certified nursing assistant, you can see the audience size here growing up. So as you can see, all the interests that I have selected here are certified nursing assistants. Some of them are come under job titles, some of them are coming under field of study, and some of them are coming under general interest. And I know for a fact that all of these work. This has been tested by me and my team in a lot of niches already. So we know that this works. And you can clearly see here that the audience size has gone up to 560,000 people. So that's more than 500,000. So definitely a good enough niche to be in. Similarly, I want to show you the audience size for aircraft mechanic also. So let me just clear this up and select the gender as male. The age is fine here. So let's try aircraft mechanic and see what comes up. All right. There was one big interest that used to come. Let me see if I can find that. Okay, yeah, so this is the one I was looking for. And though, guys, even though it says aircraft maintenance technician, that's why you need to do your research, right? Though it says aircraft maintenance technician, and it's coming under an additional interest. So whenever it comes under additional interest, it gives a good audience size, a bigger audience size generally compared to job titles. And even though it says technician, like I know that in this niche, people use the word technician and mechanic interchangeably. So I know that this interest works well. So I have selected this additional interest and some job titles and two field of study. And you can see the audience size here has built up to 140,000. So this anything above 1 lakh is good enough to be in that niche. If you come up with an extraordinary design in this niche, even in this niche, you can get sales in hundreds or 200s, or who knows, like the top sellers. I've seen designs in aircraft mechanic niche with a top sale of 1,000 with just one design. So definitely something worth trying. And I'm not saying that you should be in these two niches. Please don't just go after these two niches. I just wanted to give you a plan to drill down the niches that you want to target and the niches that you want to be in. That's why I encourage you to do your research as much as possible, because the more you research, the more you know. All right, guys. So talking about research, the next slide is actually about research. So let's get to this. So coming up with t-shirt phrase that sells. All right. So guys, I want you to get this inside your mind and remember this thing always, that t-shirt phrase or the content is the most important thing in a campaign. So and I have given you an example here. See, look at this design. Just says Papa, the man, the myth, the legend. See how simple this design is. All right. And it is one of the top selling designs on Teespring. It has more than 60,000 sales. And it's just because it's one of the major niches and the content is extraordinary. It's a very simple design. So the other thing I want you to remember is, if the content is great and the design is normal, you could have good sales, you could have extraordinary sales. But if the content is bad, even if you get the best design made in the world, there's no way you can get that shirt to sell. Because when we are putting a shirt in front of somebody, it's the content that they relate to first. If the content makes them feel good about their job, or they feel happy seeing the content, there's a very good chance that they'll buy it. But if the content is not good, even if we have the best design in the world, we're not going to make sales. All right. So when you are doing research, be very particular about it. Put emphasis on the content. And try coming up with a content that is extraordinary. So that's why I'll talk about coming up with content in the next slide. So let's proceed. So before we do that, I wanted to tell you the types of t-shirt ideas that are there. So generally speaking, broadly, there are two types of t-shirt ideas. So one is niche specific, like you see here, and the other is scalable. In what I mean by niche specific is that the content would be very specific and has terms related to that niche. For example, this one reads, when we read this, I think you'll understand better. He's the bolt to my nut, spark to my plug, key to my starter, piston to my cylinder, engine to my life, I love my mechanic. So you can see there are a lot of terms that only mechanics will be able to relate to here. So when they see this, there's a very good chance that they're going to relate it to it. And the second type of idea is a scalable idea. So it says, I might be a mechanic, but I can't fix stupid. So a scalable idea is such an idea that can be by changing the job name, you can replicate it in a lot of different niches. For example, this can become, I might be a nurse, but I can't fix stupid. Or I might be a carpenter, but I can't fix stupid. I might be a welder, but I can't fix stupid. See the see where we are going with this? This is, you just replace the name of the job, and this can fit into any niche. So this is a scalable idea, and this is a niche-specific idea. I encourage you to try a combination of both of these. There are advantages and disadvantages to both of them. For example, in the niche-specific, it's actually very, very targeted. When somebody sees a niche specific design, every mechanic would feel that it's made just for them. So that is the advantage that we have with niche specific ideas. And the advantage with scalable idea is that once you come up with it and you find that it's a winner, you don't have to do much work after that. You can just duplicate it in as many niches, and there is a good chance that it will be successful in few or a lot of the other niches as well. So all right guys, and there's one more tip that I wanted to share that's working really well in my company. So what we do with that is we combine a scalable idea with a niche specific idea, and I'll try to give you an example. So here this is here let's try to combine this scalable idea and try to make it niche specific. So we might say something like, I might be a mechanic but I can't fix stupid, but I can screw it. So that's an example for mechanics. Similarly, we can do something for carpenters, which can read, I might be a mechanic, I can't fix stupid, but I can hammer it. So you can see here that hammer is a niche specific word to carpenters, and screw is a niche specific word to mechanics. So we took a scalable idea, we twisted it and modified it to make it a combination of a niche specific and scalable idea, and then we increase our chances of having success even more with doing this thing. Right. And guys, while we are at it, I wanted to give you a disclaimer that even though I'm showing these designs, I'm showing them just because they came in the market 1 or 2 years back. So I don't want to rip anyone off. I know how difficult it is to come up with original ideas that are going to sell. I'm showing this because these are 1 to 2 years old, and people who originally came up with this idea must have made all their profits from these designs. I did not show any design that is a decent one. And I also encourage you to not copy any design or also a content directly. You can take inspiration from something, you can take an idea, modify it in your own way, and then if you use it and come up with an original design, then it's fine. But please don't be a copycat. It's a very big problem in our industry, and it doesn't help anyone. If you come up with an original idea and an original design, there's a much better chance that you will succeed as well, because you will present something in the market that is not existing. It's okay to draw inspiration. You make changes to it, and then you use a content, and then you use it. It's fine, but don't take anything directly, because it's just not right. All right. So, with that, let's move on to the research resources that I use in my company. And these are all the resources that I'd be showing you here are free resources, but they are also top class resources. We also use some paid resources, but I'm not going to talk about them here. These are good enough. In fact, some of these are better than the paid ones that we are using. So you should be good enough with using just these. So Pinterest is the best resource tool that we use in our company, hands down. There's nothing better than Pinterest. It's actually a gold mine of ideas. And let me see if I can show you how to do research on Pinterest. So, okay, let me open up my Pinterest and open Pinterest.com. All right. So guys, as you know that when you go to Pinterest, people can repin it. So if a pin has a repin, it means that it already has a social proof, and it shows that people are already liking it. And there is an extension in Chrome called Pin on Top. What it does is it brings the pins that have the highest number of repins at top. This way we can see the content that people are liking the most, and if we know that people are already liking it, if we draw inspiration from that and use it for our t-shirt, there is a very good chance that we can have success. So let me demonstrate it for the niches that I told you about earlier. So let's try aircraft mechanic and see what comes up in Pinterest. So, and let's use the pin on top tool. So let's ask it to load it for 10 pages and sort by repins and see what it brings. Similarly, while it's doing the job, let's do the same thing for certified nursing assistants as well. It takes some time because we have asked the extension to load it up to 10 pages. For the sake of showing, let's load it up to 5 pages, as it will be quicker for certified nursing assistant. Still loading. I think it's done. All right. Okay, let's see if we have something from here which we can draw inspiration for our t-shirt designs. Okay, this is one that can be used for pilots. So while I'm seeing it, I'm getting ideas for my other niches. Again, a good one for pilots. Getting a lot of ideas for pilots here. So see, a very good one came here. It says aircraft mechanics brain, and I know that this has been done for mechanics already. So you can see that it brings it's a well labeled diagram showing, it's a funny one, showing aircraft mechanics brain, and it shows the function that various parts achieve. So what you can do is you can go level further, and you can read a little bit about aircraft mechanics and see the skills they have and the features they have, and maybe replace some of them with those. That way you can make it more niche specific. You can use some of these and use some of your own and make it more niche specific, get a new design done that is more creative than this one. And there's a good chance that you can make sales. So this is already in shirt. This has 247 rupees. Sure, this would have gotten some sales. Now this is a scalable idea that can be tried for any niche. If you think it's expensive to hire a quality aircraft mechanic, just wait until you hire a crappy one. This is one content that has done very well for mechanics. It may not have been tried for aircraft mechanics. You can give your own spin to this one, and definitely this can definitely be worth giving a shot. This is an awesome one here, though it has only 63 repins. Takes years to design it, weeks to build it, seconds to break it, and a lifetime to keep it airworthy. I'm sure that the aircraft mechanics are going to love this one. You can see that this is not on a t-shirt, this is just a phrase, and I'm sure that this can serve as an inspiration for a really good shirt. You can take this phrase, modify it, and come up with a really good design, and there's a good chance that you can make sales. So you can see that we are getting a lot of these, and you don't have to just wanted to give you a brief idea of how to go about it. You don't have to limit yourself here. What you can do is we just tried aircraft mechanic. You can also try aircraft mechanic humor. There are a lot of keywords that you should try. Aircraft mechanic humor, aircraft mechanic funny. I don't know. There are a lot of other keywords also that you can try. Quotes, phrases. And like I said, spend as much time as you can on research, because this is what will ultimately get you results. So never spend less time on research. Just keep priority to research, and understand that if you spend proper time on it, at the end it will give you very good results. Just like I did another search with aircraft mechanic humor, and you can see some different results came up. Can see another one here. This is a mug. So for aircraft mechanic, it doesn't mention the word aircraft mechanic anywhere, but it's a very clever way of doing it. Just says spells the word mechanic wrongly, and at the end it says I fix planes. So you can see it's a gold mine of ideas. You can just keep on going through it the whole day, and still if you come up with new keywords, it will keep giving you new ideas. So, and I know that everybody talks about Pinterest. And the reason why everybody does it is because it simply works. And if you spend ample time on it, it will give you a lot of ideas. Just try to be original, and if you like, make some changes to it and make it more niche specific, you can come up with some really good designs. So you can see the results that came for CNA in the background. Alright, this is a funny one. Only a CNA can clean up a resident covered from head to toe in BM, wash their hands, and say heading to lunch. So, yeah. So, it's specifically for CNA. It's a e-card. It's not done on shirt. So, here also there's scope to modify it and do it for a shirt. And guys, just look at the number of repins, 4.8k, 4.3k. So there are so many people on Pinterest who have repinned it, and these people guys must be CNA, and this has been done with just organic traffic. Just imagine the number of people you can reach with advertising on Facebook. And if you come up with a good content and a design, you can really sell a lot of these shirts. behind every greatness is a running CNA. So this is a scalable idea that has been applied to some niches. I'm not sure, it may not have been applied for CNA. This is again a good, great idea. CNA's prayer, I know the prayers work well. There are a lot of shirts which say a nurse's prayer. So CNA's prayer is also something that's going to work well. See this, by looking at this, you can get inspiration for doing designs. See how creatively the word heart is written in the heart shape. See another angels who wear scrubs, maybe something that simple wouldn't work now, but you can take it as one part and add some more content to it and it might work then. So you can see that Pinterest is actually a very good resource, and I just searched by keyword, you can replicate the same thing that we did for aircraft mechanic. You can see it even gives you suggestion, so you can try with this. But and don't just stop here, come up with your own keywords also. Sometimes when I'm searching for aircraft mechanic, I'd not just search for aircraft mechanic, but I'll also search for mechanics, and a lot of things that are applicable for mechanics would also apply for aircraft mechanic. I just me and my team would just give it our own spin and edit and make changes to it, so it has even better chances of success. So I encourage you all people also to do the same thing. All right, so let's see the other ways of research. All right, so that was Pinterest. So the second is FB search. So with this, what you can see is the things that are working well in the things that are working well in the t-shirt industry, or you can search for other sites as well. But what I use it is for seeing the trending things in print on demand industry, and I'll show you how it works. It helps you better understand the audience. So what we do is we go to fbsearch.com and say we do teespring.com mechanic, and you need to be logged in inside your Facebook account. So what it will do is it will redirect you to Facebook, and you can see the results are coming here. But the better way to view it is, okay, so the better way to view it is going to photos, and it will bring up all the public photos. Okay, now so you need to go and click to photos and scroll to the bottom and click on see all public photos. What it will do then is it will bring all the photos and in a nice format where you can see 6 to 8 of them in a single screen. And the great thing about this is it also shows you engagement. So what you can do, what I do is I keep a look at the engagement. I first look at the engagement and I see if there is enough engagement, then only I pay attention to it. For example, this one has 43 likes or 100. I only look at posts that have more than 1,000 engagement. So I take a look at this one. For example, it says arguing with a mechanic is like wrestling a pig in mud. Sooner or later you'll realize the pig likes it. So that's a funny one, again a scalable idea that can be applied to a lot of niches. So this one, but guys, it's also important to look at the date here. So this one came in 2015, so even though it might work now, if applied to other niches, there's also a good chance that it might have already been done in the major niches since it came a long time back. But that's the beauty of it. If you give your own spin to any particular content, even if it came in the market 2 to 3 years ago, there's still a very good chance that you can make it work. See, there's another one with more than 1,000 likes, and with this one also a lot of results will come up. You can keep going through it and taking a look at the ones that already has audience proof with a lot of engagement. I never dreamed I'd grow up to be a super sexy mechanic, but here I'm killing it. Again, a scalable idea that has been done in a lot of niches. You'll see some that has less engagement, you'll see some that have huge engagement, say more than 10,000, some with 20,000 likes, 20,000 shares. So you can pay more attention to them and see That way you'll also better understand the audience and see the kind of stuff that they are liking. So even if you don't you don't have to do the same content, but if you get an understanding of the audience, you can do something similar along similar lines. All right, guys. So these are the first two resources, and you can do the same thing. The third one is Google Images, and don't underestimate the potential that's there in Google Images. You can also get a lot of great results from Google Images. So let's go to Google Images and try aircraft mechanic. Okay, aircraft mechanic, funny quotes. And we see some great ones in the beginning. You can teach a monkey to fly an aircraft, but not to fix it. I know that this was done on a short a year or two back, and it became a bestseller. It did really well. So you can see that the content that comes on Google Images is also top class. You just need to sort out and see which ones are the good ones and which ones are bad ones. And while you're doing it, I forgot to mention it, but whenever you are doing your research, you should always have a research folder ready where you save all the images at one place, so that once you are done collecting, say, 50 to 100 different inspiration images, you can go through them and apply it in the niche and make modifications to the content, combine two or three of them, and see whatever way you come up with content, because it's good to have it organized at one place so that you can go through it all. This is a good one. You can make some changes to it. For example, when I open this, something comes in my so when you open this, it says single married, it's complicated in a relationship in aviation. What you can do here is, for example, maybe remove the it's complicated and in a relationship part and leave the single and married field unchecked, and then have that checkbox and say in aviation and don't have time for your crap. This is a scalable idea that we are trying in some niches that is working well for us. So that is what I mean by saying don't take anything directly, draw inspiration from it and make changes to it. This only makes the content stronger and something that is unique to you. So you'll not find it anywhere else in the market. So people are going to better relate to it. And guys, you can see that it keeps on coming you keep on going through this and it will keep you giving results. And there will be a lot of repetition. You don't have to bother about it. Just keep going through it and you'll find a lot of ideas, and it will get your creative juices flowing. And please don't just stop there. I encourage you, there are a lot of other resources. You should go through Instagram, eBay, Tumblr, Reddit. And you shouldn't even limit yourself there. You should go to niche specific forums and get to know the terms that your competition wouldn't know otherwise. You can go know niche specific terms, the inside jokes that these people talk about. This way you'll have a competitive advantage over your competition, and it is especially important in today's world, because the print on demand industry has gotten competitive. So you need to be doing it differently from the average Joe so that you have a competitive advantage. There are ways to do it. Like, for example, when you go to eBay and Amazon, you can, when you search with these same quotes, you can even see the number of sales, I think, on eBay, and you can see the reviews on Amazon. So if there are a lot of reviews, it means that a lot of people have already bought it. So that way you can also see the type of content that is already selling. So you can come up with something similar. And like I have been mentioning, the more you research, the more you know. All right, guys. So let's get to the next part, which is getting designs that sell. So that's why in this slide, I have put 6 designs in 6 different niches. And do you see a trend here? I want you to spot a trend and I'll give you some time. All right. Do you see a trend here?
these are all best-selling designs in these six different niches. So it's that all of these designs are simple designs. You think that you can do these designs, these are very simple designs. For example, this one can be done even in Microsoft Paint. You don't even need to have a professional photo editing software. And it's the same for all of these. All of these are very simple designs, and all of these are among the top sellers on Teespring. Again, I'm showing these designs because these designs came at least a year back. So people who did these designs must have extracted all the profits out of it. So it's not that I'm revealing designs of anyone. So you can see that this is just a design for American Mechanics, where they've used a flag and just an image here of a wrench. This can be done very simply, and it's the same about all these designs. The reason why I wanted to show you this part is because simple sells the best. So you don't have to get the most complicated design or most extraordinary design to give yourself the chance of success. Like I mentioned, this Papa design has sold more than 60,000 units, and it's the simplest. It's one of the simplest designs that I have ever seen, and it's the same for all of these niches. See, this is also just text-based design. So three of them are totally text-based. One doesn't have any text at all, and the designs in which images are used are also very simple ones. So you can learn to do this kind of designs on your own, and it's not even going to take much time. So just remember this, that simple sells the best. You don't have to come up with very complicated designs. All right, guys. So if you're starting out, I suggest that you do your designs on your own, because you will have to spend money on advertising. So you need to be saving in the designs, a design aspect, and simple sells the best. You don't have to do anything very complicated. Learn it. GIMP is a free software that you can use, or you can get yourself a copy of Photoshop. There are a lot of tutorials available on YouTube. Just go through them, and I'd say you don't even need to spend like hours and hours on it. If you go through it for one day, I think on the second day you should be ready to do simple designs like this, and you can do it in the right way. All right. If you are inclined and you want to do a lot of designs, what you can do is you can outsource to fiverr.com, and you can get designs done there for $5 to $10. And for such simple designs, I think $5 to $10 is more than enough. If you are patient enough and you're ready to wait for one to three days, you can get this type of designs done for definitely done for $5. And for $10, you can get even more complicated designs than this. These are very simple ones. You can get complicated designs done for $10. And once you start having success, you can even look at hiring a freelancer on Upwork.com. If you get to that level, I hired somebody from Upwork.com. I have the template ready. So if somebody is inclined and you start seeing some success and you want to do that, just reach out to me and I can share that template that you can use for your job posting and get somebody from there. But the gist of it is that if you're getting started, I encourage you to do it yourself, simply because simple sells the best, and you should be saving most of your money for advertising aspect when you are starting out. So guys, this is it for this video. I'll talk about the advertising and getting your pages ready, making the post on Facebook, and advertising. The advertising is is in itself a very big, vast topic. But before we get to that, it was important to cover this aspect. People talk a lot about how their Facebook ads are not working and all that, but it all starts from the content and design. And in a lot of the cases, I see that they say that their ads are not working, and when I ask them to show me their design, I see that there's more to be done from the design part and the content part. I feel that it's lacking in the content part. So obviously, if the content is not up to the mark, there's no way that you can sell even with the best advertising in the world. All right, you can give yourself the best chance only when your content is strong, your design is strong, you are in the right niches, and you do your research right. So I would say that please have emphasis on getting these things right, and I'll be talking about the ads and the other aspects in the next videos. All right, guys, See you in the next videos. Bye.